Gemini, this is a peek at your partner for the week of April the 9th through April the 15th, 2023. Universal energies, show me what I need to see for the partner of the star sign of Gemini for April the 9th through April the 15th, 2023. Universal energies, show me what I need to see for the partner of the star sign of Gemini for April the 9th through April the 15th, 2023. Universal energies, show me what I need to see for the partner of the star sign of Gemini for April the 9th through April the 15th, 2023. Show me. You guys, subscribe, like, comment, and share these videos. If this does not resonate with you, check your moon, rising, and Venus sign videos. I do not read reversals. So, Gemini. Gemini, this is a peek at your partner. Gemini, your partner has the devil. Your partner has the four of wands. Your partner has the five of wands. Your partner has the world. And your partner has justice. So, Gemini, your partner has the devil. Could be dealing with a Capricorn, but this devil energy can speak of a toxic energy that is looming over you guys' relationship. And what makes it toxic is it's restrictive and binding. Someone may be obsessive, possessive, controlling, abusive. Someone may have an addiction to sex, drugs, drinking, smoking, working too much, money, attention, gambling, sports, video games, eating too much, anything that a person does too much of. Or someone here is in a full-blown relationship somewhere else, causing this toxic energy to loom over you guys' relationship. So listen, Gemini could be dealing with a Capricorn, but when we're dealing with this devil energy, this can speak of something being toxic, restrictive, and binding. This can speak of a legal binding contract, but also temptation. Clarify the devil for Gemini's partner. Clarify the devil for Gemini's partner. Clarify the devil for Gemini's partner. It is clarified with the Two of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. This is juggling. Now, this could be juggling two ideas. Should I? Shouldn't I? Will I? Won't I? This can be your partner managing many things at once, weighing up the pros and the cons, or juggling two relationships. So listen, Gemini, your partner could tell me that they're weighing things up, trying to decide should they, shouldn't they? Or your partner's telling me that juggling is taking place here. Now, your partner could tell me that, hey, you know, it's toxic because of juggling. Your partner could tell me that, you know, they're maybe, you know, weighing things up, trying to decide here concerning maybe some type of legal binding contract, okay? We'll see. Your partner has the Four of Wands. Aries, Leo, or Sag. This is the structure, the foundation of a solid, stable, committed relationship. This is leveling up the relationship. This is the marriage ceremony card. Now, we could be speaking of a celebration, a birthday party, anniversary party, baby shower, the home. But this is the marriage ceremony card. So, Gemini, this can be about your partner's foundation, their stability. This can be about commitment, marriage, leveling up. This can be a ceremony, celebration, or even property. Clarify the Four of Wands for Gemini's partner. Clarify the Four of Wands for Gemini's partner. Clarify the Four of Wands for Gemini's partner. It is clarified with the Four of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. This is your partner holding back, holding off, keeping something close to their chest. Now, this is also a card of a miser, a penny pincher, someone who's holding back their coins, saving their money, being stingy, someone who's closed off, blocked off, not opening up. So, Gemini, your partner could tell me that they're closed off, blocked off, not opening up. Your partner could tell me that they're holding on to their coins, saving their money, being stingy, or they're keeping something close to their chest here. You know, they could be saving money for maybe some type of property. Yes. Your partner could tell me that they're holding back from purchasing some type of property because it could be a legal binding contract here. However, your partner could tell me that they're holding off on commitment here, a legal binding contract, maybe trying to weigh things up and decide. Gemini, your partner has the Five of Wands. Aries, Leo, or Sag. This is conflict. This is fussing, fighting, disagreements, arguments, jealousy, competition, drama. But this can also speak to your partner being conflicted within about something. So, Gemini, your partner could tell me that they're conflicted within about something, or some type of conflict, disagreement, argument, drama has taken place here. Clarify the Five of Wands for Gemini's partner. Clarify the Five of Wands for Gemini's partner. Clarify the Five of Wands for Gemini's partner. It is clarified with the Page of Wands. Aries, Leo, or Sag. This is news or a message about a passionate, creative new endeavor. Now, this can be the news about the spark of a new idea, the news, a message about some type of passionate action that needs to take place. But this wand is symbolic of the male phallic and using the male phallic to be intimate. So, passionate messages or news of passion. So, Gemini, listen, your partner could tell me that they're receiving passionate messages. They could be sending out passionate messages. Very well could be that we found passionate messages and heard the news of someone sharing passion, or this is a heated discussion or argument. Clarify the Page of Wands for Gemini's partner. Clarify the Page of Wands for Gemini's partner. Clarify the Page of Wands for Gemini's partner. It is clarified with the Three of Pentacles. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. This is making plans to meet up, making plans to partner up, to work together on a contract or a project. This is teamwork. This is collaboration. Now, this can speak to there being a third party involved, but this can also speak to your partner being willing to work on it or put in the work. So, listen, Gemini, you know, your partner could tell me that this is all work or business. Your partner could tell me that they're willing to work on it, willing to put in the work. Your partner could tell me that this is some type of an agreement or contract collaboration, or there's a third party. Now, your partner could tell me that, hey, you know, you guys may have had some passionate, heated discussion or argument, and they're wanting to work things out here. Your partner could tell me that you guys had this heated, passionate discussion or argument over some type of an agreement or a contract here, maybe a marital contract here. Your partner could tell me that we had this heated discussion or argument because we found passionate messages and heard the news of someone sharing passion with a third party. Someone was juggling here. You know, could have been a secret that they were keeping close to their chest here, or they're kind of closed off with going into some type of commitment because they feel like you were juggling. Gemini, your partner has the world. So your partner may be at a distance from you, either emotionally or physically at a distance. Your partner may have traveled recently or will travel in the near future. But the world symbolizes closing out a cycle to start a new cycle, closing out a chapter to start a new chapter. So, Gemini, your partner could tell me that there's distance between you guys, emotional distance or geographical distance. Your partner could tell me that a cycle is closing out completely, or someone is wanting to come back around again. Clarify the world for Gemini's partner. Clarify the world for Gemini's partner. Clarify the world for Gemini's partner. It is clarified with the Queen of Cups, Scorpio, Cancer, or Pisces. This queen is a very loving, kind, compassionate queen. This is a nurturing queen. This is the mothering energy. She's very intuitive and psychic, and she searches her emotions. Could be dealing with Scorpio, Cancer, or Pisces, or someone with water prominent in their charts. However, your partner could be taking on the energy of this Queen of Cups, using their intuition concerning something or searching their emotions concerning something. Also, with the Queen of Cups, this is a mothering, nurturing energy. So you could be dealing with the parent of your child. Clarify the Queen of Cups for Gemini's partner. Clarify the Queen of Cups for Gemini's partner. Clarify the Queen of Cups for Gemini's partner. It is clarified with you, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius, the Queen of Swords. This queen is a no-nonsense type of queen. She already knows the truth. She'll let you speak your truth to bring more clarity, but she has no problems with cutting people, places, and things out of her life that no longer serve her. So, Gemini, this is you. Clarify the Queen of Swords for Gemini's partner. Clarify the Queen of Swords for Gemini's partner. What does Gemini's partner think of Gemini? What does Gemini's partner think of Gemini? Clarify the Queen of Swords for Gemini's partner. It is clarified with the Five of Cups, Scorpio, Cancer, or Pisces. This is you feeling remorse and regrets, hurt, crying on the inside over all the time that has spilled out, all the effort and energy that has spilled out, all the love that has spilled out. This is you mourning the loss of this relationship, disappointed on how things panned out in the relationship. So, Gemini, ask what does your partner think of you? Your partner may think that you're hurt, you're mourning, you're disappointed. However, your partner could think that you're feeling remorse and regret for the part that you played. I feel like a cycle is closing out here. You know, someone's hurt, someone's mourning, someone's disappointed, because your partner could also tell me that when it comes to you, they're hurt, mourning, and disappointed here, or they're feeling remorse and regret. Could also be that, yes, someone here is hurt, but they're searching their emotions about maybe coming back around again, okay? Wanting to start this cycle over because they're feeling remorse and regret for the part that they played, but there's a cycle closing out here. Gemini, your partner has the Queen of Swords. Gemini, Libra, I'm sorry. Did I say the Queen of Swords? That's you. Your partner has justice. Could be dealing with a Libra, but your partner may be calling for karmic justice, saying, you know what? I'm a good person. I put good out there. I'm just expecting that good to return to me. Or your partner saying that someone did me so wrong and so dirty. I'm calling for karmic justice. I want them to get exactly what they deserve. Or your partner's dealing with something in the justice system. So, Gemini could be dealing with a Libra, but your partner could tell me that, hey, something isn't fair, something is imbalanced, something isn't just. Your partner could tell me that someone wants to come in and right a wrong and bring justice to a situation, or you're dealing with something in the justice system. Clarify justice for Gemini's partner. Clarify justice for Gemini's partner. Clarify justice for Gemini's partner. It is clarified with the Ten of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. This is financial success and abundance. This is where two people come together in a long-standing committed relationship, joining together their assets and resources to build something to pass down from generation to generation, creating a legacy. So we're speaking of marriage, commitment, home, family, assets, resources, property, inheritance, legacy. So, Gemini, listen, this can be about your partner's money, assets, resources, abundance. Your partner could tell me that someone has commitment on the brain. However, in tarot, tens are ending, so it could be an ending to you guys' commitment, marriage, living together situation, or family dynamics. Now, listen, yes, someone very well may have commitment on the brain, wanting to go to the justice of the peace with a legal binding contract, but your partner is telling me that they're conflicted within. Should I, shouldn't I? Should I, shouldn't I? An argument was taking place here, and they're kind of holding back from going into some type of commitment. However, your partner could tell me that you guys already had this established commitment, marriage, living together situation, family dynamics going on, but it's ending, okay? And maybe in the justice system, maybe there's some type of fight going on over some type of an agreement here because something was toxic, okay? And still debating this contract of ending it. Gemini, this is a peek at your partner for the week of April the 9th through April the 15th, 2023. You guys, give me feedback, subscribe, like, comment, and share. And follow me on Twitter at Her Immortal Madge, MAJ. And I'll see you guys next week. Peace.